literally nothing. Okay, that's perfectly fine. So you lost maybe, you lost 6% in the midterm so far. But you have 13% of the midterm and you have the entire final. You can start 60% of the midterm. Okay. Oh. maybe even 75%, I don't know. I think 75% of the victim. If you got nothing from before, this accounts for 75% of the victim, or, you know, 65 or something in this range. So you still have at least 35% of the victim and the entire fight. So if you, I really mean it, if you literally got nothing, that's perfectly fine, you can start fresh from now. Okay. Any questions? We'll have generalizations today, so let's see. For an airplane, X is forward, Y is to the right of the pilot, and Z is downward to complete the triad. Okay, X forward, Y to the right of the airplane or the pilot, and Z downward. This is X, Z, down here, I have X body, and here is my Y body. Any question about the axes, please? And since we are starting fresh now, almost has nothing to do from before. If you have any question, just come up with it. Yes, please.
Is Z going down negative or positive?
This is positive. This is the positive convention that I'm talking about. Okay. Any question? Okay, the velocity vector, yeah. Just imagine it, but that's fine.
Probably their angle.
Exactly. I mean, it has to, yeah. So, the velocity vector has three components. Well, it's a three-dimensional world, right? So, although Einstein said that it's four-dimensional. Anyway, so the velocity vector of the airplane has three components, U, V, W, okay? And you can see the correspondence. U along the x-axis, so here is the, if you can write, you look at the components, okay? U, V, W. So, here is the U component, which is the largest component. Here is the Z and W component, okay? This is the velocity of the airplane in the XZ plane. And we typically fix the airplane, hold it in place, and have the air coming to it, right? Can you tell me what is this angle? What's that angle? This is the angle of attack, very good. So from this picture, alpha, its exact definition is tan inverse W over U, okay? This is the exact definition of the angle of attack. Any question, folks? You need to get this, cover here with this picture, till the end of it, because it's the basis to almost whatever coming. Any question? In this plane, however, anybody doesn't see the difference? I mean, this is the side view, which I like to call it the front view, because it's the most revealing view. And this is the top view, of course, so viewing the airplane from top. Okay. So when you view the airplane from the top, here is my velocity vector, V in general. Okay? This is in general. The airplane, of course, doesn't move like this. Look at this. This is the airplane is pointing in that direction, yet it's moving sideways. Okay? In general, it can happen, of course, and we don't like that to happen. So the little v component is along the y-axis. It is the little v component. What is this angle? What's that angle? You're not supposed to know. But it's all what I want to say is that it's an angle of attack light kind of thing, right? But from the other plane. This is a new thing here that we're defining. It's called, it's denoted by beta, and it's called the side slip angle. Beta is the side slip angle. So this is one new thing here that we're defining. Beta is the side slip angle, and as you can see, something undesirable. We don't want any side slip during the flight. Okay? So whenever the airplane has a little V component, a little V velocity component, it has a side slip. It is the relation. Can you tell me the relation between little V, beta, and large V? Just the geometry. V is, sine beta, right? So V0 means beta 0. Little V0 means beta 0. You want to kill that. Because if there is little V component, means that the airplane is moving sideways. Okay. Any question?
Professor?
Yes, please.
So the U, V, and W are the components of vectors of the velocity, or like for the plane, right?
Yes.
Okay.
The airplane has a rigid body moving in three dimensions. Its velocity vector is a vector in three dimensions. It has three components. They are U, V, W, along the respective axes. Of course, you can see that the largest component is the U. You have a little bit of W to keep a small angle of attack to give me some lift, right? And we should fly at zero V. Any question? If you have any question, please come for it. Like I said, this should be a new topic. So if you didn't study, don't feel ashamed, because it has nothing to do with before. Yes, please. This is a very good question. No, even when we turn, we do something called coordinated turn, which means that beta has to be always zero. So, because think about this. Here is the velocity vector of the airplane, and here is the airplane. So this guy, this angle is big. When I want to do turn, actually I want them to be aligned together, which means beta zero, and turn them simultaneously together to the direction I want, okay? I don't want this guy to turn, but the airplane doesn't turn with it, right? This doesn't help me. And vice versa, I don't want this airplane to turn while the velocity vector doesn't turn, okay?
Just in working cause size limit.
Well, disturbance one of the sources, for sure. Any question? So we nominally fly at zero beta, but we might get disturbance. Like the same here, we nominally fly at some alpha, but we might get disturbance, so we want to make sure that whenever we get disturbance, the airplane rejects that disturbance naturally without the interference of the pilot or the autopilot, okay? It's your job as a flight mechanics person.
What is that? Seven?
Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah. It's V. This is the velocity of the airplane. So, the moments. So far, we have been dealing with only one moment. Do you remember what's its name? What's its symbol? What's the only moment that we have been computing so far? Pitching moment and its symbol?
M,
right? So for three dimensions, we have three moments on each axis. So far we have been dealing with M or its coefficient Cm, right? Now we can introduce two new moments, L and N, and as you can see, it's L and N. L is about the x-axis, M is about the y-axis, N is about the z-axis. And their positive convention follows the right-hand rule. So this is the airplane, and this is the x-axis, longitudinally forward. You put your thumb with that axis, then your right hand cannot be with the left hand. So the left hand will be wrong, okay? So your thumb with the axis, then your right hand gives you the positive sense. So the positive rolling moment of the airplane about x-axis is to the right, okay? So this guy is called the rolling moment, and it's positive to the right, okay? You should not keep this in your memory, positive to the right. You always get it by your right-hand rule, okay? Pitching moment, you already know what is its sign convention. It's positive what? Pitching moment, positive what? So this pitching moment is about the y-axis, here is the y-axis, right? So the moment about the y-axis is either pitching up or pitching down, right? So put your thumb with the y-axis, then this is the positive sense, it's pitching up, you already know that. So this guy we call it pitching, and it's positive upward, pitching up. Then the last moment, we call the yawing moment. It's about Z. Here is your Z-axis. Z-axis for the airplane is downward. Okay, it's positive downward, it's not up. Positive downward. Please put your thumb downward. And this is the positive sense. The airplane yaw to the right. This is yawing moment. Positive right. Any question about any of these? As you can see, they are almost have nothing to do with before. Any question, please? Okay, so let's see, what we have been studying so far, in the big picture. The big picture is that maybe this is the nominal flight condition of the airplane. I'm flying at some angle of attack. The issue is that we are a little bit worried if the airplane experiences some increase in the angle of attack, for example. What will happen? Will it just go all the way and fall down, or will it come back to its natural flight condition? So let's see from this picture. Just forget what we have been studying so far. Okay? Let's see what will happen if the angle of attack increases. If the angle of attack increases, what will happen? Angle of attack is an aerodynamic term, right?
So if you're dealing with an aerodynamic term, you immediately think about the aerodynamic surfaces, right? Which I'll not think about the engine, of course. I'll think about the wing and tail. These are the aerodynamic surfaces, right? If the angle of attack increases, forget about any details that we learn. If the angle of attack increases, what will happen to the lift here? Increase. What will happen to the lift there? Increase. The lift will increase on every aerodynamic surface on the airplane, right? You increase the angle of attack on everything. I don't care if it's by the same amount or not, but everything will increase, right? The issue is that the lift here is very close to the CG, so it will not affect. But the lift there, so the increase in the angle of attack will increase the angle of attack of the tail force, which in turn will increase the lift force here. And this lift force is far away from the CG. You remember the name of this guy? This distance? Little thing. The damn little thing. One of the hardest things in this room. Anyway. So, because this is far away from the CG, it will create a negative pitching moment, right? Or down pitching moment. That would return the airplane to its equilibrium, right? Because the airplane, we said we will assume that the airplane is experiencing an increase in the angle of attack. So the airplane pitches up a little bit as a disturbance. So I want to reject that disturbance, i.e. I want to create a negative pitching moment to restore me to its equilibrium, to the original equilibrium. I'm saying I want to create, in fact, I will not create, I'm saying it will naturally happen. Will naturally happen. If the angle of attack increases, the lift here and there will naturally increase. And if the lift here increases, it will create a pitching moment, naturally, without the interference of the pilot or the autopilot. So the airplane is naturally stable. We call it inherently stable. Okay? Any question about that? So you can immediately see from the big picture here that just adding tail here immediately makes the airplane stable, right? If you remove the horizontal tail, the airplane will not be stable. You need to design the wing very wise manner to make that happen if you don't have a tail. The same thing, so we studied this in detail and derived expressions. This was our topic in the past. Today it's a new topic, so this is why I'm encouraging you, please, let's start fresh and focus. Okay? We have the same thing here. We supposed to fly at zero side slip, now I'm flying at some side slip angle. So as we usually do, we fix the airplane, and here is the air velocity coming to the airplane. Okay? If I'm originally flying at zero side slip, now I have this side slip. What will happen? This beta thing, this angle, is an angle of attack-like angle. Again, it's an aerodynamic term, so I will think about the aerodynamic surfaces, either the wing or the horizontal tail or the vertical tail.